And so those are all justice issues also. And so yeah. we need to be a voice for those voice. Who have no voice. Because voice. In many countries, women have very little voice. In many Middle Eastern countries, African countries, Asian countries, women have very, very little voice. But I was so excited. The meeting last night was incredible because it was focused on the nation of Armenia, yeah. which is a small nation north of Iran. It used to be part of the Soviet Union. It's an independent nation now. Armenia and Ethiopia kind of compete in terms of which one was the world's first right. official Christian nation, and they both became the Christianity became the official religion of both of those nations around the same time in the 300s, and so Christianity has an ancient heritage in the nation of Armenia.
Yeah.
But we were listening to the testimonies of people both from the business sector, from NGOs working in humanitarian projects in Armenia. And then from some government leaders, including the ambassador, who opened up the session last night. But I was so excited to hear how the partnership between the business sector and humanitarian NGOs working in a place like Armenia were able to bring such an upgrade, economic upgrade, to women in that nation that's sustainable. But they talked about not just wanting to have sustainability.
Right.
But
right.
thriving
was the word.
That the end all was not sustainability, yeah. just to sustain,
yeah.
but the end all was to be able to help people come to a place where they were thriving,
yeah.
thriving economically, thriving in their families, thriving in their nation, okay. thriving in their livelihoods, and just how small. Small initiatives, small entrepreneurial upstarts can have an incredible
yeah.
influence mm-hmm. to change the lives of so many women. One Greek-Armenian woman that was there, a young woman named Sylvia, was sharing about how she was raised in America, born in, there, but raised in America, how she went back to rediscover her Armenian roots.
Yes.
And how she began a small company making preserves,
right.
fruit preserves, like
right.
jams, fruit preserves from the fruit that would be hand-picked, organically grown in Armenia. So handcrafted fruit preserves made by Armenian women and then
beautiful.
Exported around the world.
Absolutely.
But what was incredible about it was that her main advertising tool for this was, as she came to America and started sharing with different companies, to British Airways, to other airplanes, to use her preserves on their flights, restaurants, chains, and so forth. She told them the story of the different women who were making these
yeah,
preserves.
The stories,
and
guys.
And the transformation
yes,
that
yes,
happened
yes.
as a result of them beginning these small businesses and partnering with her in this incredible business. And so it's been a great just 2 days here already.
And one of the things that I believe that Apostle just hit on, and I want to bring some emphasis to this, particularly for those of your seven mountains and understand marketplace ministry, is every session that we have been on, the world has been saying to women, we want to hear your voice.
Yeah.
And hasn't it been?
Absolutely.
We want to hear your voice. We want to hear your story. We want to know the story behind your pain, the story behind your project, the story behind your mission, the story behind your entrepreneurial pursuit.
Right.
So it's just been the power of voice and the power of story, as we've been here.
We have heard that in just about every session.
She's been screaming.
She's been screaming almost. I mean, almost like I had to hold her back from doing a little Kojic two-step
no,
in the United Nations.
I was dancing at one point.
She wanted to
okay.
shout because, you know, this is the power of speak coach par excellence here to help people find their voice.
Oh, it's been great.
So that has been one of the main themes in terms of empowering women is helping women to find their voice
yes.
and become a voice for change.
Yes.
And listen, that's not just women, any brothers, any of you men that are watching.
Yeah.
This is also for you. This is about us really becoming a voice for the kingdom of God,
power
a voice
right.
for good news,
voice,
a voice on on the mountains,
yes.
A voice for the Lord Jesus Christ, a voice for justice, a voice for change, a voice for transformation.
Come on,
so each and every one of you, you have a voice on the inside,
yes.
of you that is
screaming,
that is
shadow.
Waiting to get liberated,
yeah.
a voice, an anointed voice that God wants you to shout on the mountaintops,
Jesus.
For the Lord Jesus Christ,
oh,
an
my.
Anointed voice to proclaim the good news, an anointed
oh,
voice to be salt and light influence on the mountain, an anointed voice. So this has been an incredible theme, and it's a major theme concerning the whole movement of transformation.
Yes.
Whether we speak of it in terms of from a secular context,
mm-hmm.
or we speak of it from a kingdom context, mm-hmm. becoming a voice, no longer being silent, but becoming a voice is a major, major, mm-hmm. major theme.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord gave this to Apostle Yolanda several years ago,
yeah.
that she had
yeah.
to develop that coaching and those courses and so forth to be able to help people become leaders through finding their voice,
yeah.
leaders of change, transformation agents, through finding their voice and being able to passionately tell their
Absolutely.
Story.
Absolutely.
And each and every one of you, you have a story
yeah.
to tell.
Yeah.
There's a story on
There's
the inside
story.
Of you that the world needs
oh, my.
To hear.
Oh,
and,
my.
And but you need to be able to learn how to be able to effectively communicate,
mm-hmm.
even in non-church settings,
non-church.
Your voice, to communicate your story mm-hmm. through an anointed voice. That releases passion, that stirs and inspires and motivates people toward change.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, that change begins first with knowing the Lord Jesus Christ.
Absolutely.
And so we are ambassadors for Christ. Ambassadors have to be articulate. Ambassadors have to be able to communicate. And as ambassadors for Christ, we need to be able to have our voice be heard.
Yeah. You know, listen, this word ambassador is really taking on a new meaning now that we are stepping on the grounds here at the UN. When Christ said he has called us to be new creations that really move and shape with ambassadorship, I understand why now. And I want to inspire you that we really need to be ambassadors
yes.
on those mountains, ambassadors in the community. Even when we talk about voice, we're talking about developing a first line
yes.
of leadership so that we're not, you know, we all can't be in the same place or the same sphere of influence. So I just wanted to encourage you all across the globe, across
yes.
the continents, across the nation
yes.
of this country, that we need to be developing leadership
yes.
strategies, and we need to develop an understanding of potent
yes.
ambassadorship,
yes. Yes.
That we really become a voice and new languages.
Yes.
Ladies
new language.
And gents, new language.
New language.
Cannot use the same old language to articulate the new wineskin
yes.
that Christ has given us, so
exactly.
that becomes critical.
Yes, we have to learn a new language. Listen, there's a new language is about
transformation
and about change around the world, and we need to be able to learn that language that we can convey the good news upon the mountains
yeah.
but with language that the world can understand,
mm-hmm.
that we can package mm-hmm. this good news in
mm-hmm.
such a way that the world
yes.
begins to understand it and not just discount us and discredit us and put us in a corner of irrelevancy and just saying, oh, that's just some crazy church folks
mm-hmm,
that
mm-hmm.
all they think about just shouting and dancing and saying hallelujah
yeah.
and not realize that we actually have solutions, that we have the Spirit of God, the Spirit of the Creator on the inside
yeah.
of us, and we have solutions.
Yeah, we are double and triple packed. That's really true. I mean, the world has so much intelligence and so much, you know, technology and so much ability, but you and I, we are carrying an apostle and all of those that are with us, we are carrying double and triple ammunition
yes.
For the world. We can take down systems that are demonic and dark, but at the same time release people who are bound and captive. This is really the commission that Christ has given to us
yes.
and we get to do it with new models. We don't have to do the old way, the same old thing. We get to bring new innovation, you know, new extraordinary influence to things that are just waiting for you and I. So we just wanted to inspire you today from the
That's
UN.
Right.
We want you to know that you are the ones that the world is waiting on. There are no others. If you don't do it, then it won't be done. So your peace is important. Can we
Amen.
Say that? Your peace
Absolutely.
Is important.
Listen, you're ambassadors for the Lord Jesus Christ. Yolanda, Paul, and I are here as ambassadors for
yeah.
the Lord Jesus
yeah.
Christ.
Yeah.
We're here representing in the United Nations. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Because the nations are our inheritance.
Absolutely.
And right here in downtown New York City, Manhattan, the nations are gathered together.
Wow.
Every nation on the planet, on this little piece of real estate,
my God,
gathered together here to discuss global issues. Mm. And we're here to represent the kingdom of God. Hallelujah.
Mm.
And I pray that many of you have an opportunity to come here, not only to go to the nations on short-term missions trips, to experience what God
Absolutely.
Wants to do through you, to touch and bless people in the nations, but to have an opportunity to even to come to venues like this and spend 2, 3, 4 days just to be able to be in this small piece of real estate, in this tall building in Manhattan, where the nations have gathered together
Absolutely.
In this place.
You know, that was the one thing, I know we got to close, but that was the one thing that the Father promised Christ. He said, I'm going to give you the nations as an inheritance.
That's right.
And imagine that. And right here in New York at the UN, the nations gather all the time. They're here. We don't have to go far. We don't have to get a plane ticket far. We can come right to New York City and step into the nations and touch people all over the world. So that's really exciting.
So let you see again.
All right,
see.
So we're gonna show you guys. We're gonna show you guys the room that we're sitting in here. Isn't that awesome?
So all of the nations of the world are represented in these seats here. Every nation has its the name of its country at the table here, behind each one, in front of each one of these chairs, and there's the main podium up front where the UN Secretary General opens up and panelists moderate panels. You'll see even in front of me here are other groups that participate. There's West Africa Economic and Monetary Union, Union for the Mediterranean, the Pacific Community, all kinds of various different groups that are here. So you have the International Monetary Fund, you have all kinds of various different NGOs, non-governmental organizations that are here represented at the United Nations in these discussions and so forth. So a lot of policy, global policy, is decided in these places. Wars, treaties, security issues, famine issues, civil wars, all kinds of various things, policies are decided in this place.
Right.
And it's so incredibly important that we, since we are kingdom ambassadors, which representing Christ, to bring the nations to Christ as his inheritance, go into all the world, preach the gospel to every creature. And so because of that, we have a responsibility to understand that as ambassadors, we want to be able to see the kingdom of God come and influence in places like the United Nations, in the Capitol building in Washington, D.C., in the Senate, in the Congress, in the White House, in the Supreme Court, in your state governments, in your city governments, in your local county governments. God wants you to be involved beyond the four walls of your church.
Wow.
That 2 or 3 hours you come to church on a Sunday morning, it's to worship, it's to get empowered, it's to govern and legislate, to pray, but then the rest of the week you're out there to be salt and light influence, to make a difference in society, to change your city, your county, your state, and your nation, to find what mountain of influence you're called to. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And some of you call to the mountain of government, you may find yourself here in the United Nations.
Absolutely.
You pray and God will open the door for you
Absolutely.
To come and to be here. And I just want to encourage you that let me see if I can get myself back on here.
Turn around again. Well, while Apostle's doing that, really, you know, this is our PowerScope time. And, you know, I don't take a long time. I know you're at lunch and doing various things for your family, your businesses, your ministries. But we're very clear that this is the time and season, a new era in which God is mobilizing his children to go far and near. I want you to imagine for a minute that you can go to places and do things that you have not done ever before. I mean, never before have we just been sitting in the UN with the kingdom agenda as we're doing today. So I want you to dream big. I want you to know that nothing is impossible when we think about the ambassadors moving the kingdom agenda on earth. Remember, Jesus only said, let it as it is in heaven, so let it be on earth. So we're bringing peace, real peace, not just play peace, you know, not just a little peace. We're bringing the real peace of the kingdom on earth, along with the love and the empowerment and all of the things that Christ died to give us.
Exactly.
So it's exciting.
You know, when God gave me the vision for Epic Global Network last year, this is one of the things he put on my heart, to begin to pray for an open door to be able to become involved in the United Nations and even also in Washington, D.C. And within just a couple of months of praying that prayer, I knew God would open those doors, and he did, actually through one of my spiritual sons who has an NGO that is accredited by the United Nations.
Awesome.
Who resides in Paris, France. And so the Lord opened that door and granted that prayer, and so I believe that we will have more and more opportunities here, and I believe next that